It is time now for Better Money, and today we're talking about how to find a financial advisor. Joel Johnson is a certified financial planner and managing partner at Johnson Brunetti, and he's answering some frequently asked questions about this. It's a big decision for people.
It's a big decision. So many email questions come into the program on retirement. How do I choose a financial advisor? How do I choose an estate planning attorney? So we're going to drill down a little bit here today on how to choose a financial advisor.
Okay, so let's talk about what Tom asked. He said there are so many different types of advisors, such as investment management, wealth management, retirement planning. What is the difference between these? And what should I be looking for?
So most of the time for Tom, it's more a name than it is a difference in the person. So a wealth manager, an investment manager, a retirement planning manager, a financial planner, they all do the same thing for the most part. Sometimes there's a specialty, but it's just how the person wants to hold themselves out there. The best thing to look for is somebody that's got some credentials, but also maybe somebody that's working with somebody that you know.
And
that's
going to
be kind of the theme of all the questions today, is find somebody that's credentialed and very competent, but maybe somebody that's been referred to you by a friend. The Certified Financial Planner designation is a good one to look for, too,
okay.
The CFP.
Because not everyone who is just telling you how to buy stocks would be a Certified Financial Planner, probably.
Not at all. That's kind of the elite designation in our industry, which is that Certified Financial Planner. It's like a CPA for accountants.
Okay, so look for that. Shirley wanted to know, how can I be sure I'm working with a trusted advisor? I don't want to get burned by an advisor. You do hear horror stories.
Yeah, you sure do. You know, you hear about the Bernie Madoff, which is, of course, the big one. But you also hear other situations where maybe somebody takes money out of a client's account, or they just sell a product that's not good for the client. So again, look for credentials, look for somebody, and I think there's another question coming up, somebody who's a fiduciary, who's required to have a higher standard, and also just ask around a little bit. Find somebody that has a good reputation and maybe that's working with somebody that you know.
Yeah, okay, Linda, that's the question you're talking about. She asked, should I make sure my advisor is a fiduciary?
Yeah, and this is really, really important. And where the big difference here is a stockbroker is not a fiduciary. They just have to sell something that's suitable. Fiduciary has to act by law in the best interest of the client.
Okay, so those are some qualifications you want to look for. Eric was asking for clarification on how advisors are paid. And this could be different depending on who you go with and the plan they offer you.
That's correct. And there's three basic ways. An advisor can bill by the hour. An advisor can charge fees based on the amount of money that they manage. An advisor can receive commissions. There's a lot of people that want to say, well, commissions are bad or fees are bad. It really doesn't matter that much. What matters is the person you're working with, that you can trust that person you're working with and that they're acting in the best interest. The more popular way these days is to earn fees so that there isn't a little bit less of a conflict of interest problem.
Yeah, then you're on the same team. They don't make money unless you
make exactly.
Money. Okay. So to get a little more clarification, you have a free offer for our viewers. It's the Money Map book, and there is a chapter in it on choosing a financial advisor. To get Joel's free offer, all you have to do is go to bettermoneytv.com, look for the box that says click here to receive your free offer from Johnson Brunetti, and you'll send this to everyone for free.
Absolutely. It's a great book because I wrote it.
Okay.
And it's got the last chapter is how to choose a financial advisor.
All righty. Thank you so much, Joel. That's Better Money.